long time ago, when the world was younger, and the thoughts of the great empire were as new as the freshly driven snow, what we could do was see a reaction more clearly, without the haze of time and intent and circumstance intervening. But that's what it became to be known as. Its alibi, its alias, its M.O. was a great marching procession of itself, instigating, flagellating, annihilating, reciprocating. This is what it did. It worked in concert with some of our fears. It knew how to prey upon them. It had this sneaking itch in the pit of its belly of what our next move would be. And it wasn't afraid to act on it. It didn't have any particular ties. It didn't need to be in an area where any one resource was concentrated. All it needed was this inkling, this gut instinct that it came to trust because it believed it to be originating from very primal origins. So there it was, trying to follow a feeling, trying to latch on to this old instinct. So what were we to do? We, the thinkers who took more time, slower albeit, but perhaps more considered, and considerate for sure. All we did was outsmart it. So then the hard feelings come, and all sorts of talk arises. Why did we outsmart it? Were we jealous, really? Why wouldn't we play it on its own terms? As if we should have de-evolved to enter a battlefield. Not quite the thing we had in mind, but still, our eyes off the ball, the prize drifting away. Because as we celebrated and congratulated ourselves on this achievement of evolution, they stole the trophy, and they ran. Because those brains think better things like that. Would have taken us longer to arrive as a possible outcome, us stealing the trophy and running. We would have had to eliminate so much more before that. But they did not. That was higher up on their list. That was more of an option, more of a priority all along. So therefore, they got away with it. And that was the beginning, as I mentioned at the start of this, long ago, so long ago.